Hey everyone, it's Star, your communications coordinator here. I hope that you had a really great first week of shelter in place. For me, it flew by, but I hope that you had a decent week. I'm gonna ramble for the first minute to let people log on here. If you had something that happened this week that would feel weird in a normal world, but makes perfect sense in a pandemic world, why don't you comment below? For instance, I scored some toilet paper yesterday, and I've been living on that high for like 24 hours. I mean, that doesn't make any sense in a normal world, but in a pandemic world, wow. It was really great. So comment below, let us know that you're listening tonight. Thanks for tuning in. I just kind of wanted to share some thoughts I've been having, kind of deeper thoughts, not anything light, but it's something that God's been speaking to me for the past week. So maybe you can relate to the experience I'm going to tell you about, maybe not, but oh well. Last Sunday, I was in a really, really bad place. Last Sunday night, my depression was just, it was pretty present. And it had been brewing for a few weeks. I knew it was coming, and it was followed by a couple of days of some really bad anxiety. And I mean, it was hard for me because I was in a really good place before COVID-19 started. And so if you know anything about me, you know that I'm either a 0 or a 100 type of gal. Either I'm really into something or I'm just not the biggest fan of it. There's really no in between. And that comes true when I feel things. And some of you might be the same way. When you feel things, you feel them so strongly and there's just no other way about it. There was a lot of work that had to be done at Resurrection with the coronavirus. I knew it was coming as soon as it was called a pandemic. I knew that my job was gonna get like super crazy intense, and that's okay. I love my job and I love pouring myself into it, but I had to put all other things on the back burner. And I know that we're not the only organization that had to do that. And it was hard for me. And I kept telling myself, wait, there's work to be done. Just, you can feel the emotions. Let's just get the big things over with, right? And I kept pushing away these moments of stress and these moments of tears. And I was just like, let's just get the big stuff done. And I became really short-tempered. And I was getting mad at family and friends and coworkers. And I was only thinking about myself, and it was just not the best coping tactic, and it caught up with me last Sunday night. I told myself, okay, the work's been done. This is the situation we're in, and it's time to mourn everything that's happened. So that's what I did. I spent about an hour in a state of kind of darkness, of bad thinking. And I just let myself feel the situation. I was mourning the work. You see, it's Holy Week right now, and Holy Week is the Super Bowl of Christianity. And it is our craziest week of the year, but it's also, it's an amazing part of the year because we all got to come together and worship together and have all of these fun experiences together celebrating the risen King, right? And I mourned that we're not doing that, and it sucked. Oh, it was so hard. And I'm not trying to belittle what we're doing online, but you know, if you've been in the walls of Resurrection Monticello in the last year, you know God's been moving. And it just felt like Satan came and was like, you gotta rethink how to do ministry, otherwise I've won. And I was coping with that, and I'm getting married later this year in November. And I've been getting all these emails from all these vendors about cancellations, and I kept thinking about all the other brides and grooms that are making these really tough decisions regarding the one of the best days of their lives. And then I started thinking about all of the pregnant women who are scared to go into labor because they don't want to get sick when they're at the hospital. And I thought about all of the essential workers that are afraid to come home because they don't want to get anyone in their household sick. And I just let myself sit in this for about an hour. And then I began to have this moment with Jesus. And I told him, I'm sorry that I'm feeling these things. I don't want you to think I don't trust in you or that I don't think you have a plan. Here I am trying to reassure my God that I still believed in him and that I just needed to feel the humanness. As if I would need to do that. You know, I've seen the good works that God's been doing in all of this, connecting with you all online, and we're worshiping over thousands of people now online on Sunday mornings, and I know that there's good things coming out of it, but I still mourned it all. I was still upset about it all. And I just needed to feel those emotions. Because here's the thing, we can't continue to do the work in the kingdom of God if we still have that emotional baggage, that darkness, those bad thoughts, but we can't just shove them aside. We can't just pretend that they don't exist because they do and they are real and we have to feel them before we can move on. I think back to when I was learning how to ride a bike. My dad taught me, and I wasn't the type of kid where if I fell, I'd run crying to my parent and I needed to be held. No, I was the kid who fell and it hurt, but I needed to feel it first and then move on. It was enough for me to know that I had a protective father just by my side that was there if I needed him. So last Sunday, this is what Jesus told me to talk about. I want you to think about a really tough number, which is the number of COVID-19 deaths. Okay, but we have to think about, there's probably a rise in suicide rates right now, which is another really hard number to think about. I haven't even looked, I don't wanna look, but here's the thing, we need to be praying about that. I need you to reach out to everyone in your circle because there's people that have suffered from mental illness, that it's picking back up again. There was people that were already fighting mental illness when this started, and now they feel like the battle, they're just losing it. And now there's people that have never experienced it before in their lives that are starting to suffer from it because of this virus. And we have to pray for that because we cannot lose any more people to suicide. It's just, we can't. And here's the thing, no one knew I was feeling this way last Sunday, and that's no one's fault but mine, because depression is scary and it tells you that you don't need to tell anybody how you're feeling. The only person I was ready to share my vulnerability with was Jesus. And that, you know, it's important to have that relationship with him. But we ought to pray that people would have more humility and understanding and hope. And I can't stress how important it is to check in on your people. Let them know that you're there. Text, call, video, pray for them. We can't diminish the situation and we can't afford to lose any people to it. We have to fight the battle and we have to worry about them. Okay, I want you to shake that out. That's a lot. It's really heavy. And I don't like talking about the heavy stuff. I want you to know that I'm excited to see how God is using this to build us up as his people. The tools that he's equipped us with and that he's training us on, and I'm excited to see the fruit of his work. But I don't want us to forget about the scary stuff. Okay, I have to get a little biblical, right? Think back to Genesis. Eve entered the world to give companionship to Adam. And we have to remember that there was something about humanity that God saw that as much as we loved and worshiped God, we still needed to be with others that were like us. And he wanted to understand it to the point where he sent his own son down, right? To experience that humanity with us. So we can't be too greedy and we can't settle into the dust too early. we can't feel like we can't be vulnerable with God because he understands it. He came down, sent his son down, and he gets it. He gets those human emotions. And he's not gonna think that you're doubting him because you're feeling that way. So if you begin to forget what God's calling us to be, I encourage you to talk to someone, because I remember a lot of scripture and a lot of attributes about God when I talk with someone. And that's how he speaks to me, and he might speak that way to you. If you need to talk, you can always message the church on Facebook, or you can text the number in the description of this video. It's usually me that responds, but I want to make sure you're okay, and we want to pray for you as a staff and a leadership team at Resurrection. We won't judge you, and if you don't want to reach out to us, we get it, but reach out to somebody. Reach out to a relative, a friend, a coworker. Just say, hey, I'm not doing okay with all of this, and I don't know what I need, but I need you to know that I'm not doing okay, and if you need to, you know, check in on me every once in a while, great. That would be really helpful. And if you're on the receiving end of that, you know, don't go like, oh, what can I do for you? Just being there, being an ear, lending that ear is enough. Just be there for someone. You don't have to understand what they're going through. You don't have to have walked in it yourself. You just, sometimes you gotta be that ear. And when in doubt, Jesus has a great ear too that you can talk to. And that is honestly one of the first steps that I would recommend is really talking to Jesus. So I'm gonna pray. God, you've created us in your image. But sometimes we feel like we falter when we feel even the littlest bit of human emotion. And God, I'm sorry if any one of us has ever doubted you. I ask for your forgiveness, that you'd forgive us. And God, I also respect the emotions that you've given us and how they've morphed over time to where we are now in 2020. God, it feels like we are feeling things that are so much farther away than where you ever wanted us to be, but God, you knew the minute that apple was bitten into where this would all go. And I respect you for that, and I praise you. I ask you to protect our minds and to lift us up and strengthen us. God, we know it's okay to grieve as long as we still see your light at the end of the tunnel. We have to always be sure to return so we can keep bringing those hurting to you. We know that you got this in your hands, but we can't help but feel sad and angry. I pray that we would feel comfortable enough with you to share in that and to allow you to heal us. God, you're working miracles today and every day, and I pray that you work a miracle on us tonight. I pray that you have us in your possession, that we cannot falter if you are on our side. And I pray that you protect us in the loneliness and the darkness. I pray that you speak to us and show us what we have to look forward to, and most importantly, that you will lead us back to one another. We're not meant to walk alone. God, make your presence known as we finish our night, as we settle into bed, and as we drift into deep sleep. I pray that you would heal the pain and the hurt and the neglect and the sadness while we sleep. And I pray that you would be there in those moments so that we can wake up the hope of you in the morning. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, before you sign off for the night, I posted a video link in the description of one of my favorite worship videos, and I would invite you to spend some time worshiping God tonight. Even if you did it this morning, just take some time and remember him. Just remember him. I want you to feel reassured, and I want you to remember what God calls us to be and what God promises he'll do. So please go check out that video. Thanks for tuning in tonight. We'll be live again tomorrow night at 6:30 p.m. with Pastor Jedediah. Again, don't be afraid to reach out. We love you guys.